by the several little kids who came to me with money, and they probably gave out everything they have in their piggy banks. That's all they can do. And I wish we can follow their example, not to give everything you have in your piggy bank, but at least try to do your best. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala reward you for this. Ameen. A few days ago, I was reading about the biggest masajid in North America, and I came to this sad reality that the biggest masjid in North America is built by who? In Calgary? The Ahmadiyya Qadiriyya. The biggest masjid in North America is built and run in 2008 by the Ahmadiyya movement. They are not even Muslim. Deviant Muslim groups like Ahmadiyya, Qadiriyya, and the Baha'is, they are building masajid all over the place, they are running them. And they know that the only way to survive as a minority is to stick together. And this is something all of us need to learn from. We need to stick together, we need to do our best, and we need to contribute the best we can. Because we have the truth in our side. We have Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala on our side. So don't let all the deviant groups take care of this places of worship, and we Muslims, we know we have Allah on our side, we have the truth on our side, and we hesitate to give. Why? We know that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will give you back. And this is what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala calls the charity in the Quran. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala يسميها قَرْضًا حَسَنًا مَنْ ذَا الَّذِي يُقْرِضُ اللَّهَ قَرْضًا حَسَنًا فَيُضَاعِفَهُ لَهُ أَضْعَافًا كَثِيرًا. لأن الله سبحانه وتعالى يعلم إنه إذا أمر بإعطاء الصدقة تقول أتروح مش هترجع تاني. إنما الله سبحانه وتعالى يسميها قرض، والقرض أن الله سبحانه وتعالى يأخذه منك ويضاعفه ويعطيه لك مرة ثانية. فلن يضيع. الله سبحانه وتعالى calls charity in the Quran a loan, which means in the case of any loan that it will be given back to you, multiplied infinitely. So don't hesitate. Put your trust in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and don't hesitate. اليوم إن شاء الله نحكي عن إحدى الوسائل المعينة على القرب من الله سبحانه وتعالى وهي الشكر والحمد. كلما شكرت الله سبحانه وتعالى وكلما أحسست في قلبك أن الله سبحانه وتعالى هو المنعم وهو الرزاق فإن الله سبحانه وتعالى يبارك لك ويقربك منه. لئن شكرتم لأزيدنكم. The means for today, for tonight, for getting closer to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is to show gratitude to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for everything that you have. If you have a wife and children, if you have a house, if you have a job, if you have a car, then believe me, you are one of the chosen few. There are millions and billions in this world who don't have a wife, they don't have children, they don't have a job, they don't eat three meals a day. They don't have a car. There are millions who are wifeless, husbandless, childless, carless, moneyless, jobless, homeless, and all the lists there is in the dictionary. So you are one of the chosen few. فَلَا بُدَّ أَن تَشْكُرَ اللَّهُ سُبْحَانَهُ وَتَعَالَى عَلَى نِعَمْهِ لَإِنَّ النِّعَمْ إِذَا لَمْ تُشْكَرْ زَالَتْ. If you don't thank Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for what you have, then the ni'mah will be removed from you. Allah will give it to somebody else, those who will thank for what they have. كيف يشكر الإنسان النعمة؟ على الأقل ثلاثة وسائل. الوسيلة الأولى أن تشعر في قلبك أن الله سبحانه وتعالى هو المنعم. كما قال تعالى وما بكم من نعمة فمن الله. So you have to feel in your heart that everything that you are, everything that you have, everything that you own is from Allah. And this is what Allah says in the Quran. Whatever you have is from Allah. When you came to this life, you didn't have nothing, man. وَاللَّهُ أَخْرَجَكُمْ مِنْ بُطُونِ أُمَّهَاتِكُمْ لَا تَعْلَمُونَ شَيْءٍ وَجَعَلَ لَكُمُ السَّمْعَ وَالْأَبْصَارَ وَالْأَفْئِدَةَ قَلِيلًا مَا تَشْكُرُونَ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala brought you forth out of the wombs of your mothers. Then He gave you the ability to hear and see and think, little do you thank. You came out knowing nothing, having nothing. Then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gave you everything. But many people, they refuse to show gratitude to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. The second way of showing gratitude and thanks and praise to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is to thank Him with your tongue. saying alhamdulillah. يقول النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم في الحديث الصحيح إن الله لا يرضى من العبد أن يأكل الأكلة فيحمده عليها ويشرب الشربة فيحمده عليها. The Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم says in the authentic hadith that Allah is pleased with you whenever He gives you something to eat, you say alhamdulillah for the food. Whenever He gives you something to drink, you say alhamdulillah for the drink. Allah is pleased with you. And the same is also true for the money, the car, the wife, the kids, everything. الوسيلة الثالثة للشكر هي مساعدة المحتاج والتبرع على الغير وإعطاء حق الله وحق الفقير. So the third way of showing gratitude to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is to help those who are less fortunate. You have to give out something to help those who are in need. And when you give a charity, when you give a contribution, you're not doing people a favor. This is the right on you. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala يقول في القرآن الكريم والذين في أموالهم حق معلوم للسائل والمحروم. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala لم يسميها فضل ولكن سماها حق. This is the حق on you. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, He's talking about the righteous one, المؤمنون. They are the ones who give out in charity because the poor and the needy, they have a right on them. It is not a favor, it's a right. نختم بقصة بسيطة جدا وردت في صحيح البخاري ومسلم. يقول النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم إن ثلاثة رجال كان أحدهم أقرع والآخر أبرص والثالث أعمى وكانوا فقراء معدمين. فدعوا الله سبحانه وتعالى أن يرفع ما بهم من ضر وأن يوسع لهم في أرزاقهم. ووعد الله سبحانه وتعالى إن هو أنعم عليهم لا يتصدقن على الناس. هيتبرعوا ويغرقوا الناس فلوس. فجاء ملك إلى الأول اللي هو الأقرع وجاء إلى الثاني الأبرص والأعمى وأزال ما بهم من مرض ومن ضيق وأعطاهم مصاري جعلهم أغنى الناس. أعطى لأحدهم جمالا والآخر بقرا والثالث غنما فصاروا أغنياء. والأقرع طلع له شعر جابوا على الجنب كده عمل الفلق. وفي بعض الناس الفلق بيبقى واسع خالص. والثاني يعني أعطاه الله سبحانه وتعالى جلدا جميلا وجعله وسيما. والثالث رد الله عليه بصره. ثم نزل الملك نفس الملك اللي أعطاهم الأموال ورد عليهم البصر وكذا نزل في صورة فقير وجاء للأول وقال كنت أقرعا دميما وكذا والله سبحانه وتعالى أعطاه. فقال لا أنا كنت ورثت هذا المال كابرا عن كابر. أنا باشا ابن باشا تمام وما لأحد عندي في هذا المال نصيب والحقوق كثيرة وكذا. وطارده وشتمه وسبسبه وهزبه ولعنه ومشاه ضرب الشلوت وضرب الكفر تمام. فقال إذا كنت كما قلت إن كذبت ردك الله إلى ما كنت فيه. فرجع فقيرا معدما ورجع أقرعا كل الشعر طار لا حول ولا قوة. الثاني جاء وسأله طب أنت كنت أبرص وعشتك بالبلد والله سبحانه وتعالى وسع عليك وأعطاك الأموال وأعطاك الوجه الحسن. فقال لا إنما ورثته كابرا عن كابر. قصة في البخاري ومسلم حديث صحيح. فقال إن كنت كما قلت أو إن كنت كذبت فيما تقول ردك الله إلى ما كنت فيه. فرجع أبرصا دميما وفقد كل أمواله. وجاء للثالث الأعمى وقال لكم يعني إن الله سبحانه وتعالى وسع عليك ورد عليك كذا. قال نعم والله لقد كنت أعمى فرد الله علي بصر. فالحمد لله على ذلك. وكنت فقيرا معدما فوسع الله سبحانه وتعالى علي من الأموال. فخذ ما شئت واترك ما شئت فالمال كله لله. فقال بارك الله فيك أنت أفضل الثلاثة وبارك الله لك فيما عندك. أنا ملك وحكى له القصة. فهذا هو ثواب إعطاء الحقوق حقوق الله وحقوق العباد والتصدق على الناس. So in this hadith in Bukhari and Muslim, I'm going to give the translation very quickly. Three guys, one of them was bald, no hair, and he was ugly. The second one was a leper, he has a problem in his skin. The third one was blind. So an angel, Allah sent an angel to the three of them, and he told them, okay, I will give the first one hair, he will be handsome. The second one, the leprosy, all the skin in the problem will be gone. The third one, you will give back your sight. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will give you money and make you rich. But you have to give the right of Allah and the right of the people. Then the angel came back in the form of a poor person, bad clothing and in a bad shape. So he came to the first one. You were bald and Allah made you handsome and he made you rich. Give me something. He said, no, this is my money. I inherited it from my parents. Allah gave me nothing. So the angel said, if you are lying, then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will remove the ni'mah from you. Then boom, everything was gone. The hair was gone, the money was gone, everything. Then he went to the second one, the leper. He said, Allah gave you a good skin, he made you handsome, and he gave you money, so give me something, I'm a poor guy. He said, no, I inherited all this money from my parents, from my father. I inherited the money from my father. I inherited the good looks from my mother. Okay? No, this is not in the hadith. So if you said, if you are lying to me, then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will remove the ni'mah from you, then boom, everything was gone. And he became a leper again, he lost all his money. The third one, the blind, the guy who was blind, he came to him and he said, look at what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gave you. You were blind, he gave you money. He said, that is true, wallah, I was blind. I was in a bad shape, Allah gave me my eyes back, now I can see, and Allah gave me a lot of money. Then take whatever you want and leave whatever you want. It is not my money anyway, it's Allah's money. So he said, may Allah bless you. You passed the exams. The two guys, they failed the exams a big time. So I want each and every one of you to pass the exam. Don't fail the exam like the first two guys. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala bless you with the good looks and the beautiful hair. Ameen, ameen. Sual for yesterday, if a sister has 150 grams of gold for beautification, does she have to give zakah on that? The answer is, Imam Abu Hanifa says yes, you have to give the zakah on that money. But Imam Malik, Imam Shafi'i, and Imam Ahmad, they said no. If it is for beautification, you don't have to give the zakah on that money. However, if the gold is for business, then you have to give zakah on that money. The winner for tonight is Sister Muhammad. Inshallah, I'll give her the reward after Salat and the Tarawih. The question for tonight. 2 years ago, we had Eid on the day of Jum'ah. If you come for Salatul Eid in the morning, do you have to come for Salatul Jum'ah the same day? If you know the answer, email me at clcimam@gmail.com. Inshallah, we're continuing our fundraiser till the end of the month of Ramadan. I'm gonna keep the pledges here. They are outside. Fill them out, give them to me, or put them in the office. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala reward you for your generosity. JazakAllah.